Hey, Bob, from where I am,
there's this photo online from the Apollo 17 mission with which I am fascinated. Whenever I see it, I'm instantly awestruck at the sheer scale presented. This daunting feeling overwhelms me and leads me to admire the effort and challenge put into all of these missions. While Harrison Schmitt worked at the lunar rover of Apollo 17, his colleague Gene Cernan stepped back and took a series of images that were stitched into a panorama. It's thanks to his photos and other astronauts like him that anyone can realize the daunting reality of spaceflight.
Seen the orbiter launch morning, coming up to thrust.
It was on the dawn of February 3rd, 1984, that Bruce McCandless sat in the cockpit of the Space Shuttle Challenger. At precisely 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the shuttle rocketed off the launch pad into a 300-kilometer orbit around Earth. After 4 days in space, Bruce and his colleague Robert Stewart stepped out of the space shuttle untethered for the first time in spacewalk history. These men completed what might be one of the most daring and potentially hazardous maneuvers in spaceflight, paving the way for the future of work in space. McCandless drifted nearly 320 feet away from the shuttle in the first test of the manned maneuvering unit. During this spacewalk, though, an image was taken of McCandless as he floated off away from the shuttle. No, not this image, but this one. Bruce, a tiny figure above the Earth below, shows off what, at the time, was something no person in history had accomplished. This truly daunting moment is forever remembered in this photograph. To keep with the theme, spacewalks have become commonplace in crewed space exploration today. The ISS astronauts would have spacewalks every few weeks or months, and while operating, the shuttle would have at least one EVA for almost every mission. But some spacewalks in history stand above all others, either for their significance in spaceflight history or simply for the circumstances of the spacewalk itself. These are the ones that really can instill a certain feeling in you. Voskhod 2, piloted by Pavel Belyayev and Alexei Leonov, sat at the Soviet Union's Baikonur Cosmodrome on March 18, 1965. Lifting off at 1 o'clock, these two men were on their way to make history, Leonov especially. Just 90 minutes after lifting off and after making just one orbit around the Earth, Voskhod 2 inflated its airlock and Alexei donned his spacesuit. As he left the craft, he placed a camera at the end of the airlock to record his spacewalk. Alexei was tasked with taking photographs of the spacecraft from the outside, and this is where problems began. As he tried bending down to reach the shutter button, Leonov realized how stiff his suit had become. Unbeknownst to him, his suit had ballooned in size due to air continuously filling it past its planned limit. So, Alexei, the first person in history to leave their spacecraft in space, was stuck and could not get back in the airlock. To get around this issue, Leonov decided to bleed air from his suit, reducing the ballooning and allowing for mobility. After grabbing the camera recording his spacewalk, he entered headfirst into the airlock. Getting stuck turning around to shut the hatch, Leonov allowed more air out of his suit, pushing him close to decompression and sickness. Thankfully, he avoided any serious illness and made it back to the craft after just 12 minutes. But this is all left behind by the fact that Alexei had on him a suicide pill, taken if there was a failure to re-enter the spacecraft entirely. His colleague, Pavel, would have been forced to abandon him in orbit. Luckily, though, this was unnecessary, and Alexei and Pavel were able to both make it back to Earth, of course, only after landing way off trajectory and getting stranded in the Russian forest. The US quickly followed with its first spacewalk just 3 months later. They thankfully were able to avoid many of the issues that plagued the Soviets. This, however, does not negate the immensity of their accomplishments. To be the first American to perform a spacewalk was nothing short of a momentous step in spaceflight progress for the United States. With nothing more than a small, handheld maneuvering unit, astronaut Ed White made history. And it was the reliance on this relatively crude maneuvering device that really made the spacewalk daunting. However, it worked well despite potential for problems, and the spacewalk avoided major issues. As White climbed back into Gemini 4, he remarked that, "It's the saddest moment of my life." While the first spacewalks were daunting achievements of their own, there's another type of spacewalk that I believe reigns supreme above all. Far from Earth, farther than anyone else had gone, it was here around the moon that the most daring and insane spacewalks occurred. Apollo's 15.
All engines running. Launch commit. Lift off. We have liftoff at 9.
16.
Now building up to 7.7 million pounds of thrust.
And 17. Were different breed of their own. J-series missions, as they were called, were packed full of hardware and scientific equipment, including the lunar rover and the very important scientific instrument module, or SIM. The first SIM held hardware like mapping cameras to capture the lunar surface from orbit. Now, in order to bring these images back to Earth, they had to be manually retrieved by an astronaut coming back from the moon, where your only hope for rescue lies 250,000 miles and a 3-day flight away. And yet, despite the risks, these guys went and did it anyway, three different times. Apollo 15 with Al Warden, Apollo 16 with Ken Mattingly, and Apollo 17 with Ron Evans. The culmination of the space race, the Apollo program, produced some of the most widely known, world-renowned photos that still champion as memories of one of the all-time engineering feats. Seriously, photos like Buzz Aldrin standing on the moon, or him descending the ladder, or even saluting the flag, live on in memory. Apollo 17's photo of the Earth, the blue marble, is still seen today as one of the best-known images of our planet. And unfortunately, while incredible, these images often overlook key pictures taken that truly capture the vastness of space. The astronauts of the Apollo program took thousands of photos, and from these, I found the most daunting and awe-inspiring ones. At the beginning of this video, I talked about how the panorama of Shorty Crater taken during Apollo 17 creates this immense sense of the scale of extraterrestrial worlds. The moon's pristine, unweathered surface is a billion-year-old time capsule, with no atmosphere or water to erode mountains and fill craters, and no atmosphere to give a sense of distance by judging the haziness of distant objects. The moon offers an incredibly unique environment that allows one to appreciate the scale of space. Before I get into the lesser-known images, I just wanted to acknowledge a few particularly popular ones. Another one of the most viewed and best-recognized images in the world, Earthrise, taken by the astronauts from Apollo 8, creates this incredible feeling of awe and a recognition of the fragility of our planet. As Earth rose above the moon's surface for the first time since entering lunar orbit, Apollo 8 saw for the first time the Earth from the perspective of the moon. In addition to Earthrise, there's another image that stokes a similar feeling of astonishment. This image, taken by Michael Collins, the command module pilot for Apollo 11, is extraordinary in its historical perspective. Everyone, every person alive at the time the photograph was taken, including Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, who were safely inside the lunar module, were captured in that photo. Everyone except Michael Collins. To be the only person in history to capture everyone else in one photo is something I personally cannot wrap my head around. Moving into more obscure Apollo images, many photos were captured, especially in the later missions, which enact these same feelings. This is the first photo ever captured by a person on another body other than Earth. It was taken on the moon just an hour after touching down, and provides a remarkable first look at this alien world. In the foreground are the thrusters that helped stabilize and pilot the lunar module to the surface. Beyond that, nothing for miles. It was sometime after this photo was taken that the first spacewalk on the moon occurred. Throughout their time on the surface, Neil and Buzz performed a multitude of experiments and activities, like collecting samples for study back on Earth. Many photos were captured, and many show Buzz doing work on the moon. However, if you look closely at each photo, you'll notice that it's actually only photos of Buzz, not Neil. This was because the astronauts had one chest-mounted camera, and Neil ended up using it most of the time, thus taking photos of Buzz instead of himself. It was like this for all but one photo. While Neil went to work, he left the camera to Buzz. What resulted was the famous boot print photo, as well as a panorama that just so happened to capture Neil working at the lunar module. This is the only high-quality photo of Neil on the surface that exists. Sure, there's the famous Neil in the visor image, but this is the only photo directly taken of him. The first person to ever set foot on another celestial body, and all his glory is remembered in this single photo. Apollo 12 provided more amazing images and, as well, more daunting scenes of space. The scale here, the size of the astronaut compared with the rest of the scene, is unfathomable. With no atmosphere, it's unusual to see things miles away so perfectly clear, as if they were just a few feet in front of you. Having an astronaut in there provides a great context for the perspective of the vastness of the lunar surface. Additionally, the crew of Apollo 12 captured this stunning image of a crescent sliver of the Earth, shimmering in sunbeams. A beautiful, fragile world silhouetted by its own shadow. Apollo 13 could arguably have the most horrifying images. As many know, Apollo 13 experienced a catastrophic incident on its way to the moon, disabling the spacecraft and preventing the landing. What had happened was one of the oxygen tanks exploded after accidentally being ignited by sparks. The astronauts were left without sufficient oxygen nor power and also ran into a multitude of additional issues. Near the end of the emergency return mission, the now-dead service module holding the exploded oxygen tank and batteries was ejected before re-entry. It came into view and rotated just enough before getting too far away to properly see the damage caused by the explosion. This incredible, horrifying image captures just how badly crippled the spacecraft was. It is both a miracle and an engineering marvel that all three men made it back to Earth safely. Back on the surface, Apollo 14 wrapped up an era of lunar landings. Being the last mission to traverse only by foot, the astronauts pushed the envelope and walked as far as they could while making sure they had enough oxygen to make back. Thanks to their efforts, Alan Shepard and Edgar Mitchell captured these stunning images hundreds of feet away from the lunar module. The sheer scale presented here allows for an incredible look at the remote, desolate environment these men worked in and the risks they took for exploration and science. Apollo 15 ushered in a new era of lunar exploration. Known as the J missions, Apollos 15 through 17 took with them something new, the lunar rover. This completely changed the game, as astronauts were now able to travel far greater distances over the lunar surface than their predecessors. Though, of all the photos from this mission, I only found two that give me the same feelings as prior photos. Suspended in the blackness of space, Earth can be seen here as the slightest crescent sliver crossed over by a lens flare. The fragility, the smallness of the Earth, puts into perspective the enormity of space. A few days later, on the surface of the moon, David Scott and James Irwin ventured out of the rover and took this sweeping landscape image. The size of this mountain is overwhelming. With no good frame of reference, this mountain could just be a few hundred or several thousand feet high. And something about this image grabbed my attention. Something about the vastness of the lunar landscape creates just this daunting feeling. Apollo 16's daunting photographs are not as grand and vast as the others, but instead they offer a unique look at other significant moments in space exploration. This photo, taken on the surface, shows a distant lunar rover hightailing across the regolith. Thanks to the astronaut on the rover, a daunting perspective of size can be had, allowing us to also approximate distance. However, there's another even more powerful image taken on Apollo 16. Charlie Duke, the lunar module pilot on 16, left a photo of his family on the surface and snapped this photo of it. To have a family photo last up there forever is incredible. If only the image didn't likely get wiped due to solar radiation, most likely leaving it blank. At the conclusion of the Apollo program, the Apollo 17 mission accomplished more than any prior to it. The distances on the rover smashed 16's record, as well as total time on the surface, and science done. We've already seen Apollo 17 and the rover next to Shorty Crater, but this mission has more to offer. Because of the great distances covered on the rover, the astronauts of Apollo 17 were able to take amazing photos of the lunar module from afar. At nearly 2 miles, the astronauts really tested the potential of their suits to endure long-duration EVAs. The lunar module sits in the Taras-Lichow Valley, waiting for their return. Another panorama shows an astronaut next to what has since been called Tracy's Rock, a large rock found on the lunar surface. The most famous photograph from the mission, and perhaps one of the most viewed images of all time, the blue marble, taken by Apollo 17 on the return journey to Earth, stands paramount among photographs in history in terms of humankind's cultural significance. One of the few full disk images of our planet taken by a human, it shows Africa centered on a shiny blue and white disk. Every person in the world, except three, in just one photo. On July 19, 2013, the Earth stood still for a day while the Cassini spacecraft turned back to capture Earth from around Saturn. Known as the Day the Earth Smiled, This pre-known and notified event connected the world and recognized the momentous achievements of Cassini as it flew around the ringed planet. As NASA announced the event to the public, millions turned to wave at Cassini as it snapped this photo. What's even wilder is that if you zoom in on the Earth, this tiny protuberance here is the moon. The level of detail is astounding. And while there exists other photos like this from a planet such as Mars, the most impressive and astounding is the famous pale blue dot taken by Voyager 1 in 1990. The significance of this photo, though, cannot be emphasized by myself. It's Carl Sagan who, I feel, best exemplifies the importance of pale blue dot.
From this distant vantage point, the Earth might not seem of any particular interest. But for us, it's different. Consider again that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregate of our joy and suffering, thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines, every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilization, every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on a mote of dust, suspended in a sunbeam.
Lunar exploration can have strange effects on the mind, with the isolation of it all. But months before Apollo 16 launched, Charlie Duke, 16th lunar module pilot, had a strange fever dream.
My mind's one that just goes constantly. So I took a sleeping pill. Slept like a baby. I had one dream that was very vivid. In my dream, we were driving a rover up to the north. And you didn't really feel like you were out there. It was untouched. The serenity of it had a pristine purity about it. We crossed a hill. I felt, gosh, I've been here before. And there was a set of tracks out in front of us. And so we asked Houston if we could follow the tracks. And they said yes. And we turned and followed the tracks. Within an hour or so, we found this vehicle. It looked just like the rover. With two people in it. They looked like me and John. Had been there for thousands of years. It was not a nightmare type situation. Nothing like that. Probably one of the most real experiences in my life.
Among history's most beautiful quotes reigns one that, I think, is hard to beat. Climbing down the ladder after landing, Buzz Aldrin on Apollo 11 looked out over the lunar surface for the first time outside the lunar module. Aldrin's reply might be one of the most famous spoken in space exploration, second only to Neil's one small step.
Something? Magnificent sight out here. Magnificent desolation.
When planning this video, I had only intended to show off a handful of images. However, as I delved further into the archives of pictures online, more daunting photos became apparent to me. I hope this video gives an idea of the unique and alien environments that lie just outside of our doorstep, and I hope this video helps spark a new interest in space exploration and admiration for all the effort put in by the men and women of the world over the last 65 years.